Georgia always seems to produce talented running backs, and after DeAndre Swift left for the NFL last year, Zamir White is the next guy up. White is ultra-talented and was a huge recruit coming out of high school. So far this year, White has blown up, and he has one of the coolest nicknames in college football. People like to call him Zeus, but why is he called that, and why is he the next great Georgia running back? Well, in today's video, we'll tell his entire football story, go through his Georgia career so far, and why people think he could be a massive steal in the 2021 NFL draft if he declares. But first, be sure to subscribe to the channel if you love college football. But channel, give the video a like, comment your thoughts, share it with your friends, suggest a topic, and stay until the end and turn on post notifications. This will all help the video get in the algorithm, which will help my channel do better, and I can make you guys more content. Now let's get started with the rise of Zamir White. Zeus is the sky and thunder god in ancient Greek mythology, and he's basically the king of all gods. Zamir was the king of all running backs coming out of high school, but before we can talk about that, let's go back in time and tell his football story. White knew football was his ticket out of Scotland County, North Carolina, which is the fourth poorest county by household income in the country, and getting out of that was going to be hard enough, but he wasn't even supposed to be alive in the first place. Doctors weren't sure if White would actually live past 1 week old because he had a ton of medical complications when he was born, and he still has a cleft lip as a result. But as we all know, he's a fighter and he got through it. When he was in 7th grade, he would go to the gym every single day with his family friends named the Smith, and White grew up without a father present, so that dad helped him fill that void, and he still calls him Pops to this day. But as an undersized 9th grader, the buzz around White did not exist back then. He was fast and agile, but White was shuffled into the junior varsity mix like all the rest of the 14-year-old guys. But there also was something different about White. He didn't miss a day at all during the summer. His coach said, I hate to say it, but most 9th graders during the summer aren't used to football every single day, and they're kind of hit or miss. White came into high school with the nickname Zeusy, which was later shortened to Zeus, and the coach doesn't exactly know the origin of the name, but he had high expectations because of it. His best friend Jonathan Smith knew he'd be special from the flag football days, and Smith would go on to play linebacker for North Carolina. On the weekends in Laurinburg, North Carolina, his high school coach would pull up to the Scotland County field and would always see one person there drenched in sweat. It was Zamir White, unprovoked, flipping tires up and down, and getting better each day with tackling dummies and running around and catching balls. There were no cameras, there was no crowd there to watch, this was his internal motivation to be the best he could be. His coach said Zamir is one of those rare people with God-given talent and an unbelievable work ethic, and it totally paid off for Zamir. He rushed for 2,159 yards and 41 touchdowns on just 260 carries as a sophomore. He ripped off 9.7 yards per carry and totaled 1,693 yards and 26 touchdowns as a junior. He became a big-time player that schools from all around the country wanted. As a senior, he was a big-time dude, but in his first possession of a third-quarter game, he was hit from the side while on a blocking assignment. He came up awkwardly after the play and headed over to the sidelines. Soon after that, he was ready to go back in, but unfortunately, he had torn his ACL. This was a major blow to him, but it wasn't going to stop him. As a standout at Scotland High School, White made a name for himself thanks to an elite blend of speed and power that allowed him to gash defenses in multiple ways. With the ability to reach top speed through the holes and accelerate past defenders at the second level, he solidified himself as the number one running back in the nation and the 7th ranked player in the 2018 class at one time. They said, quote, he can make defenders miss or run over them. White can also run inside and outside and is a threat to go the distance every time he touches the ball. He's a very special player and has a chance to be a superstar in college. He put up insane numbers in high school. He scored over 100 touchdowns and finished his career as the 9th highest rusher in North Carolina high school football history with over 7,000 yards. He averaged over 14 yards per carry during his senior year and was given the Sam B. Nicola Award for the National High School Player of the Year. He was also an Army All-American and won all those kind of awards. When it finally came time for him to make a college decision, he was going to be able to go anywhere he wanted. It came down to Alabama, Clemson, Georgia, and Ohio State. He chose the Bulldogs because of Kirby Smart and their ability to produce high-level running backs. With White's commitment, Georgia became the school with the most ESPN 300 running back commits ever in the modern recruiting era, with 11. According to 24/7 Sports, Zamir was a 5-star recruit, the number one running back, and the 9th best player in the class of 2018. He was projected to be a stud and a star, but his journey at Georgia would be all over the place. Going into his freshman year, the depth chart was absolutely loaded with talent at running back, which included DeAndre Swift and risers like Brian Herrien and Elijah Holyfield. It started out very tough for him as he got really bad news right before the season started. In a preseason scrimmage as a freshman at Georgia, he tore his ACL in his right knee on punt coverage. For the second time in less than a calendar year, White was out with an ACL injury. White's head was clear, and he was ready to start chugging back towards full health. He spent nearly a year rehabbing while also seeking advice from fellow Georgia running backs. White chatted with guys such as Nick Chubb and Todd Gurley, and he said Herschel Walker even reached out to him. The fraternity at Running Back U truly embraced its newest brother and offered White a very strong support system, which he definitely needed. He would finally recover and get back to the field, and his coach had this to say. Coming back from an injury like that and having the confidence to be out there, he's confident in himself and he's ready to get out there and play. And that's something that's very difficult to do. As a redshirt freshman in 2019, he played in 13 of the team's 14 games, finished the year with 408 yards and 78 carries, which was third best on the team. He went for a career-high 92 yards against Baylor in the Sugar Bowl, and he scored his first touchdown against Murray State. He'd also catch two passes for 20 yards, which is something he needs to get better at. He had a lot of hype going into 2020 with DeAndre Swift leaving, and according to Sportsline, he had the 8th best odds of winning the Heisman Trophy. He went for 71 yards and a touchdown in their opening game against Arkansas, and he showed he was going to be the main option. He went for 88 yards and 2 touchdowns in a huge win over number 7 Auburn, and then put up 50 yards and a touchdown against both Tennessee and Alabama before he would finally have his breakout game, which is something that all Georgia running backs always seem to do. He went for 136 yards and a touchdown against Kentucky, and he was on track to being the next great Georgia back. Against Florida this past weekend, he took his opening carry 75 yards for a touchdown, and would finish the day with 107 yards on only 7 carries. He will play against Missouri this upcoming weekend, and I think he will have a really big game. I think he will continue to play well for the remainder of the year, and will likely declare for the 2021 NFL Draft. With his injury history though, he needs to stay healthy and leave as soon as he can to avoid any potential disaster. NFL scouts have compared him to guys like LeGarrette Blount and even Leonard Fournette. He's a true power back who sticks between the tackles and is always moving north to south, they say. He's a prime example of a downhill runner who takes advantage of a combination of impeccable balance and strength to bounce off tackles in the hole. They say once White breaks through the first level of defenders and gets out into space, he's able to finally unleash his 4.440 yard dash speed and hit the burners. Personally, I think he'll be a day 2 pick, as I don't see him as an elite level running back yet, but that could change by the end of the year. But what do you guys think? Georgia always produces running backs, so I wouldn't be surprised with anything that comes out of Zamir. And after that, I'm really curious to see who will be the next guy after him. Let me know what you guys think down in the comment section, and also give me a future video suggestion down below. Be sure to give the video a like before you go, and turn on post notifications so you never miss another upload of mine. If you're still here, check out all my other videos, including my video on the rise of DeAndre Swift, and all my other 2020 college football star videos. Hope to see you guys again soon, but until then, peace.